What's up, and welcome and stuff. Today I'm making some story elements for the Smith quest. So the Smith quest is where the captain he asks you to go investigate something that's going on with the doors are on the fritz in the lower levels of the Songbringer. He's like, go check it out, go get the Smith, and go down there and figure out what's going wrong. What's up, Pedro? Nice, man. Top 7 billion, huh? How you been, Pedro? So what I'm gonna be doing here is I'm creating a little story element where you'll get scanned by this door, and then it will open up. So let's call this Smith Door. We're on the ship. Has pattern ship teleport. Have to have the Smith. We have to be near the scanner. Yeah, weekend vacation with the girlfriend, right on. Teek, there's a voice in my ear. It's me. It's the voice of Wizard Fu. Who's the man behind the curtain? Scan, scanner. So we need a scanner entity on this screen. Lot like the scanner entity for the sword cave. Smith. Troy Smith. Call this Smith Door Scanner. I guess this could be part of this the door tile even. Oh yeah, that's a good idea. Okay. So we'll start off with the position 0, because I'm not sure where that should be. We'll give it the name scanner, and it'll have just a pixel as its art. Now when we create a door tile, we'll add this scanner entity. If I is 0, so it's the first door, and area pause dot z is k ship z, and the pattern is k pattern ship teleport. Then we'll add Smith door scanner. And what's the position? Oh, yeah, it's just P. Good guess. All right, now we should have a little scanner entity. It starts with opacity 0. Let's give it opacity 1 for now so we can see it. Will this actually work? If Find out next time. Oh, wait, I think I see the pixel. Oh, cool. Okay, so if that position was a little higher, like 15, 20, and like negative 4. Oh, we also need to test if this is the east door. Oh, it's just locked. If the door is locked. I guess we can do V if the direction. So if this is an east door, we'll go negative 10. If it's a west door, positive 10. Let me get rid of this in case I ever want to flip over these areas. Make it slightly procedural. Swap the whole thing. All right, so we should have the scanner entity. Now we need to. Yeah, that's a good place for it too. It's right in the right location. Oh wait, there, it turned red. We're being scanned. Nice. Did not open the door. Might be because of the story entity didn't give the right item. And I wanted to scan the Smith. Okay, so let's go action item. And see if it can parse it. Look kind of weird parsing or scanning. Smith. Words 0. Switch 6. Okay. Parse world items? Probably not going to be that. World item. Yeah, it's not a world item. This is going to be a specific item type. Okay, so that needs to be switch. Switch A6, I believe, is the one we want to give him. Let's make sure that does parse. And I guess we're going to have to scan rock for now. Maybe he's a different color here. Thank you. Nice, this time it's switch A6. Okay, so does that give us access to the door? We have the switch. Guess it doesn't. Why not? Oh, probably because the switch. We're on the ship, and the ship has its own special rule. Okay, so this is in door system. When we open up a door, oh, this is it right here. Wait a minute. Oh, this is locked doors. Oh, I guess that means we need to go. When we do action item. We want to unlock doors. If constants is switch or constants is key, then door system unlock the doors. So we have the area here, hero. No area. So if the story system detects that it's giving the player a key or a switch, it should automatically unlock the doors. What's up, Beachy? Welcome, how you doing? You did, yeah, I just started. Okay, why isn't this door opening? You're good? Awesome. Good to hear. Okay, so this door is west. That's not the one. There's only one door? That's not true. Can't be true. Yeah. I'm working on this little Smith quest here where you take Smith down to the lower level of Songbringer and he goes and fixes stuff. And then you go and fight Bath Cole. There couldn't have just been one of those. What happened there? Okay, yeah, this time it's working. It's the East door. We've got this door condition is switch. Oh, it's switch A7. Well. If I had given the player the right switch, maybe this would have been a little easier. Switch A7. Nice. Yeah. Oh, that was awesome. Now, I wonder if we even need this anymore. Probably do. You're working on some boss animations? Yeah, sweet. You finished the spider? That's great. I know that feeling where an animation is tricky. Oh, it does work. Okay, we didn't even need that. Well. Wah wah woo woo. So this can start at opacity 0, and that should be everything. It was a pain. Oh my God, no, eight legs. Two legs is hard. To open up both of those doors. Oh, which means we probably need to change. Oh, there's a function called like refresh. Refreshes the areas, like doors and items and all that. Area.cpp. What's up, Ed? Ed Roach. Ed Roach. Salad dogs. Ahoy! Refresh. Is it called refresh? No. What function is that? Reset? It's not reset. It's where it like restores doors. It's like it looks for a door locked. No? Yeah, what's that function called? It's called refresh. Reset, set doors, generate tiles, create. Nice. I know it's in world CPP. Restore. It's called restore. Restore tiles. Restore tile data. Open gates. Restore puzzles. Restore toggle state. I think it's restore Oh, is it not this? It's where, oh man, I don't know where the hell this is, but it's somewhere where it unlocks the doors. This is where I use the key. Where it gets the doors. World set doors. I think this is where it loads all the doors though. That's not what we want. Unlock doors. Is it? Wait a minute. What if we start in the next room? Okay, good. That's not, hasn't unlocked that door. So what the hell is actually unlocking this door? It there? It can't be there. This is where it would make sense for it to do it, but I don't think it's here either. Huh. Well, I'm wondering why the hell this door even opens. I'm like, wow, where does it unlock? Because it's not unlocking the other door. Nothing. None of those did that? What? Thank you. Okay, that's not what I meant. Where does it actually unlock the door? There's the west door. Here's one of the east doors. It's still locked. It still has this condition. It does not meet the condition at first. Good. All right, we get close to the door, let it scan us. Aha. It is activate area complete. It's automatically unlocking the doors because what? Why would check completion, what called check completion? Oh, it's right after we do a story action. Okay, it checks completion after story actions. And that automatically calls unlock the doors. And now that we have... Wait, but it still shouldn't be unlocked. Oh, because it hasn't set the doors. Oh. It might be better to actually use a key. If we use a key, then what'll happen right here is the door system will call this check completion, which will lock the doors false, and then it will come into this function here, and it will not be unlocked anymore, but it will be unlocked as soon as the player moves near it. I think that's a better way to do it. Because where the way it is now, it's using a switch. Okay, so in the story, we want to give the player key A8, and in the world, we want to give it key condition num key types. I think. Let's hope. Why did they do that? Oh, maybe there needs to be a delay before it gives you the key. No, it's just opening the door now. Damn it. I shouldn't have that key. Key aids. No good. So is it unlocking the door? Yeah, it is. Because we have what item? Map 8. What? Oh. It's using the area Z, not the level Z. Okay, so this should be constants get level Z from that. And then override that if we are on the ship. It's good that I actually had map 8, or else I wouldn't have noticed that bug. So now he should still have, yeah. Still got nothing there. Good. Now we want to turn that back on where it gives you the player the key. Good, this time it's item key A8. Nice. And it does unlock, and it's after the scan. Perfect. Oh man, there's something important I was just gonna do though. Both doors. Yes, that worked. Okay, so the key card, we don't want to show that item. All right, so we do the flux for getting an item. If the quantity is greater than zero, and if not, it's a key, and it's a ship. And I wanted to scan you if you're a little closer. It's like kind of too far away. You can totally interrupt the action. Oh, but I still have the item? Nice. Oh, that's cool. Sweet. And now, if I save, restore the game, it shouldn't cause that scan again. The door is open. Yeah, what's preventing? Oh, because it already gave me Smith Door 1. Okay, that makes sense. And it did restore the door. I wonder why it restored the door so well. Well, I guess it would have logged the doors being open in its doors. And that's why that works fine and this works fine. Cool. Yay, it all works. Right? Doors. Yep, there's those two doors. It got unlocked. Beautiful. Let's check that in. Yeah, man. Zelda. Zelda. Also Metroid. Smith Door Scanner? Smith Door Story Entity? Create the scanner entity on doors as needed? Doors are smarter about how they unlock or how they get their Z, so that's pretty important too, because that applies to alternate floors. If a dungeon had two floors and it had keys on the second floor, it wouldn't have worked before this. Luckily, the game didn't have any of that situation before. So I do need to check if regular doors are still working. And then this flux, if quantity is greater than zero and not, it's a key on the Z. Yeah. And then that's requirement for that door is the last key. Good. Okay, just checking now to see if we got a key for dungeon one. Let's go to dungeon one and see if the keys still work. Nice, it unlocked this door. Yeah. They're still locked. Hey, Rocket Bunny! What's up, man? Good, so that's ready to check in. Door scanner on Songbringer getting to lower level. Awesome! Okay, another little piece of the Smith quest is finished. You messed up your laptop? Oh no! Oh man! Oh, trying to get Linux working? Was it just your bootloader? What happened? All right, so we don't need to be here. All right, this is where I want a special pattern for the ship dungeon. Oh yeah? So you can recover? Okay, so we need we'll just do two special patterns for now. This is the ship dungeon. Well, nah, just ship, it's like the ship systems room. And then the ship engine room. So two more special rooms for the ship. Your computer's a potato! Potato! The word potato will kill you, man. Remember what it did to this to the game the other day? So we got ship systems. Well, I hope we get all restored and back to normal as soon as possible. What happened exactly? Potato the doom vegetable. Apparently you have to cook potatoes. I never knew that. I thought you could just eat potatoes raw. I'm joking. Put some butter on it, man. Cook it. Put some salt on it. Systems and ship engine. Okay. Now we need some special patterns. These special patterns to be applied in the Songbringer engine. You like raw potatoes? Wow. Yeah, potato clogs. What's up, Zilton? We're talking about potatoes, man. You walked into, two guys walk into a bar. Both of them say, ow. Easy BCD. Oh, so grub didn't work? Well, grub is a tricky thing, I told you. Grub is tricky to figure out. Especially when you're totally new to it all. Your custom built PC is working? Oh! Henko, you like wooden potatoes? Wooden potatoes! Guess what was the problem? Okay, let me try and guess. Did you turn it on? Did you turn it off and back on? It's gonna be create Dungeon Z. Dungeon Z. Ghost of Gremlins, good guess. Was the problem potatoes? Did you name your computer potato? You'll say you got it when you get. Oh, okay. What about your name? You named your computer potato. You didn't have a monitor. You had a rock on the power button and it was just turning itself on and off all the time. You forgot to put a graphics card in. You forgot your password? Good guess. Windows failed to start. I told you, man, it's tricky. What else? What else could it be? What else could Zilton? Ooh, salad dongs. For the win? For the win? You didn't have a power supply. I give up. I give up, man. No more guesses from Wizard Foo. Pattern, 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 pattern. Dungeon 1, stairs to cryo. Okay, yeah, right. Here's where's the key? Yeah, we know what key this is. All right, cool. We want to set the key. Ship dungeon. Diffuse? Oh, diffuse? Oh, man. Should have guessed. Should have kept guessing. Diffuse. I bet that was confusing. Nice one. Salad dongs. Zilton, man, that's so great. I'm so glad you got it working and it was the freaking fuse. Dude, how long did it take to figure that out? A year? Dang. If this is the, if item, it contains items, K, item, key, A, 2. So key 2, the pattern is going to be K pattern ship systems. Just another reason why Brit plugs are better. Always Batman. It was Batman's fault. Okay, and otherwise, if p.x equals the dungeon's width, shape width. Shape width minus 1, and p dot y is equal to shape width half, or shape height. Then pattern equals k pattern ship engine. There, now we should have those two special patterns, and we should verify them. Oops, I think this is Q. Yeah, Q. You can get that working. Oh, I don't know about that. No bootable device? Huh. I don't know. All right, so to verify this, it's two areas. Ship systems, we'll put something really weird in the middle. Blocks, rect. Oh, an earth wire. Oh, you went to legacy? Well, can you go in there and unset it to legacy? W2 minus 1, W2 plus 1, H2 minus 1, H2 plus 1. Okay, so here we'll put some K tile. Gargoyles, that's the ship systems, and the ship engine room, we'll set some tile lamps. That should make it pretty obvious. You can't go change it now? Oh no. There's got to be a way to reset it, I'm sure. Reset your BIOS or something like that. All right, so now we're here. I think key 2 is up this way. Isn't that the place? What room is key 2 supposed to be in? I don't know, Rocket Bunny. It depends on if your computer is all set up to boot from the USB now. You just change your EUFI settings. I think you mean EFI or UFI or something like that. Oh, maybe you do have a different acronym or whatever. Anyways, I'm not sure. You might actually have to like reset your BIOS or something to be able to get it to boot from anything now. But hopefully a bootable USB will work. Ship engine, this is at Q6310. That's right. Ship systems. Oh, it never did ship systems. No wonder. Okay, let's ver- why not? There's no key A2. No? Does it not have... Wait a minute, does it do key 1-2? Is that what it's set to? Items. Maybe it already has the item. No, it can't. Oh, it's room items. What the hell is items then? What is this variable? Oh, that's the dungeon items. We want room items. Cool. Now we got it. And Q is 2-2. Yeah, it was this room. And good, it does look like it's surrounded the whole room with these weird, or a bunch of these gargoyle tiles, so it is using that pattern. And if we go all the way to the right edge of the ship, go up a screen. Wait, we want to be 6-3. Here we go. Yeah, it's doing a bunch of lamps in the middle of this screen. Great, we've got our patterns all set up. So, we're looking good here. The next thing I want to do is have the map location reflect where you're supposed to drop the droid smith off. Z is K world max thumb levels. We want to go find that pattern we just set. K pattern ship systems. Good, now we got our map location pointing to that room. Cool. All right, and the next thing is to make it so we can drop the droid smith off there at that location. Let's check this in so far though. Good progress. Map location works. Oh yeah, we need to make sure the before boss room is locked. Yeah. I know how you feel, man. That's why I told you to back up and, if possible, don't use the bootloader. Just boot from a USB or boot from a CD. until you understand how to rewrite your own master boot record and set up a boot loader so that it can be, you know, double platform, triple platform. Linux can be like that, man. It's actually even safer to do it in a virtual machine. But listen to me. I'm trying to tell you. I told you so. Don't listen to me, man. How do you set up RAID? I have no idea. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but I mean, the boot partition, sorry, that's what I really meant to say. All right, now I want to make sure the before boss room is locked until you drop off the smith. And since they're regular doors that surround the before boss room, oh, yeah. You found a nice looking distro? Which one? So there's a couple things I need to verify, too. I can't use open walls going into the before boss room. So let's go to that before boss room location. 6, or just below it even. 6, 4, 10. Solus. Not 6410, 6310. Which is the engine room. Okay, what's Solus? I wonder if they wrote their own window manager. I'm not familiar with this one. That's not KDE. That's not KDE. No. It's not KDE. That's not GNOME either. Is it? Is that GNOME? I don't think it's GNOME. I think they wrote their own window manager for this, which is cool. So did Elementary. Very Mac reminiscent. I like it. Yeah, Elementary OS is like this. They got their own window manager, which is pretty awesome. Actually, I like the look of Solus even better. Okay, so to illustrate this fact that the walls the doors can't be like the open wall type, I'm gonna make like tons of open walls in the ship. So like num open walls, like 30 or something. Yeah. Yep. You can get it fixed. It's part the learning process, right? Oh, perfect. Look, it did an open wall right here, which is exactly what we wanted. We wanted to see that it. Cool. Okay, so we'll keep that for now. And let's guarantee that the doors into the before boss room on the ship dungeon are never open walls. And then make sure that they're locked until you have key number 7 or something. Yeah, key number 7. There you go. Yes, every problem is a learning experience. It's true. Rocket Bunny, if you take Saladong's words to heart, and I really encourage you to, then you should be saying thank you to the universe or whatever. Thank you to yourself for putting you in this situation where you have this problem with Linux, because you're learning something pretty important right now. You're learning how the boot partition works. You started looking into Vim more seriously? Nice. Yeah, it does, right? It's pretty awesome. The one thing I haven't been able to figure out, and if you figure this out, let me know. But one thing I love about Xcode is that I can jump to any function. Like if I want to jump to a function called action item, I can so quickly and easily jump to that function. All I have to know is the name of the function. And I haven't been able to figure out a way to do that in Vim. I haven't even found a plugin that can do that. But there's got to be a way to do it. There is a way to quickly jump to files, right? So if I know I want to open up door system.cpp, that's easy enough. That's easy enough to do on Vim. And so pretty much everything I do in Xcode, including autocomplete, is totally working in Vim. But I use this quick open to open up a function so often that it's almost like it's better to stay with Xcode right now until I figure that part out. You can? No way. The one, so was that the one where he was like how to get going in a week? Or was that the one where he was like how to do everything you do in Vim without plugins? Or whatever. C tags? Oh. Oh, really? Oh my God. Oh man, I gotta rewatch that video then. Shit, yeah, man. Dude. Oh, sweet. Indexing methods, classes, variables. Yes. Oh my God, this is so awesome. Oh my God, this is it right here. Totally. Right? Yeah. Well, this so far, yeah, this is where it jumps to something, but I'm sure you, if it's tagging every single function, yeah, here it is. If you want to go directly to a tag's definition, you can just use the tag command. Or you can use regular expressions with the tag command. Yeah. Oh, so sweet. Man, I'm so glad I mentioned that. You knew it, dude. That is so sweet. Nice. Well, looks like I might start using Vim. Are ISO files bigger before they're extracted? No. No, they're smaller. They're kind of compressed. With tmux? So I'm using iTerm, which is pretty sweet. I'm really liking iTerm, and I just replaced using terminal.app with iTerm basically recently in my workflow. But what's tmux? I heard about tmux too, but I don't really know. Isn't tmux just like another terminal app? It's a terminal multiplexer. Okay. Okay, so you can have multiple sessions inside the same terminal window. That's pretty awesome. So basically I could take what I'm doing now with two different iTerm windows and put them into one terminal, I guess. Oh, shared across multiple terminal sessions. Now that's sweet. So you can basically reload your session the way it was. Which is kind of a drawback of iTerm. Like once I get a certain setup, like let's say I wanted to have these two windows open like this and them to be, separated by about that much space or whatever. I mean, like this window is this wide. And I want these files open inside this window. You know what I mean? It could take a second to get this all set up. So if you could just reload a session, that sounds pretty sweet. Well, tits. Awesome. Keep that in mind. Yeah. I'm starting to see that too. I'm getting pretty close with it too. It's like being able to edit code in Vim is pretty sweet. It's way faster to like do autocomplete. It's so much more customizable. Like if like I'm so I've always been I've always hated Xcode's quick open for showing me things that I don't need. Like this, destination of symbolic link at path error. I'm never gonna ever be curious about that. I never want to quickly open that. So what's sweet about Vim is that you can just, you can pretty much fix that somehow. Yeah, there is a pretty steep learning curve. All right, we're in Create Dungeon Z, where it creates the doors. Yeah, Vim Adventures. Yeah. I did that too when I was first getting started. And then I was like, after Vim Adventures, I'm like, wait a minute. I could just change my key bindings for Songbringer so that I get more used to this. And it worked. I got totally used to those keys. Place doors, where does it do the open walls in the dungeon? No. Oh, here it is. Oh, it's in the dungeon generate. Okay, so this is something that belongs in dungeon. Dungeon open wall. Okay, so no open wall. Okay, if this if dungeon type, is that right? Yeah, dungeon type equals K dungeon ship and has bits r.flags K flag before boss continue. So that means we cannot create an open wall from or into so we want to do this here too. So if not into the room, if type is dungeon ship and has bits desktop flags continue. Funk rollers? You mean functors? Didn't work. So we still have an open wall right here. Wait a minute. This is it, right? This is where it does this. It's basically a functor is the precursor to a lambda. Same kind of concept. I mean it's what not really the yeah, I guess you could say the precursor. It's not working. Okay, well that makes sense. If it's not even the dungeon add open walls that's causing this open wall right here, then well, was it that? Okay, this always had an open wall. Oh, perhaps because it has a gate. Okay, well now, yeah, I think it's doing a gate type or door using door gate. Where does it do that? Oh no. Yeah? I don't even know the difference between the two. Oh, that's K and R. Here we go. Yeah, so K and R, right. Almond. All right, I use almond. Whitesmiths. That's a crazy one. Horsemen? That's definitely crazy. Does anybody else think that's just nuts? Pico's even worse. What's with that? Lisp is also bad. I don't like this at all. Haskell's worse. Ah! These are some weird types, man. Shit. It's freaking me out. I can't look at this anymore. Man, dude, that was getting me bothered. Okay, I think what's going on here is it's using a gate type, which don't want that either. Right, it gates, yeah, if it gates into the four bot before boss room, if there's no boss switch. So that's the dungeon flags. It's gotta be here in world. Dungeon flags boss switch. No. I know. Yeah, with the braces all the way on the right. That was definitely the worst one. Oh, yeah, right? I know how that is. What's kind of weird is when a code base is not even consistent, too. Like Coco's 2DX is like that. It's so inconsistent. Is it use door? Is it think it's door gate? All right, let's try returning from this method, see if that's the culprit. Oh yeah, Vim plugin that just makes that what does it do? Like, does it refactor all your code for you? Oh, it warns you about and even corrects style issues. Oh, that was it. Cool. So now we have a door here. Okay. Good to know. Boss switch before boss. Okay, here it is. So in the dungeon, when we're generating the dungeon and we're adding gates, we're ga adding gates to the before boss room, and the type of the dungeon is K dungeon ship. Or if it's not, we don't want it to add to before boss if it's dungeon ship. That should do it. Good, we have a door there, and we should have a door here. Yeah, good. And let's make those doors keys. Or these doors have locks. Did you mean uptime? Hey, Bafu's here today. What's up, Bafu? If it doesn't work booting from USB, you can still try and boot from, like, seriously, try resetting your BIOS somehow. Like, typically computers have some kind of key combination you can hold down, which will reset your BIOS. Or whatever they call BIOSes these days. Sorry if that's not what it's called anymore. I can't remember what it's called. So, where do we lock the door? Yeah, but that other conditional is, I think, still important. Thanks, Summer Taco, though. Right? I do want it to not add any open walls to these type of rooms. But you know what? Let me take a look at that just in one more time, because maybe that's not even necessary. Right, it adds open walls. Yeah, this is definitely necessary. Thanks, Sombra Taco, though, for reminding me about that. But yeah, this could happen. Like, right, it could if there was a lot of open walls, and it's allowing it to create open walls into the before boss room. Because these are the ones where it's not allowed. It's never allowed in a locked room or a goal room or the boss room or the boss switch room. But there's a special case for the dungeon ship. Oh wait, oh this could be simpler though. Just adding to not bits. If type equals dungeon ship, duh. Not bits or equals K flag before boss. Much simpler. And I can get rid of this whole ugly bit of code too. Now that should be better. Simpler, right? It's only now like a 3-line change so far. Okay, now the door needs to be locked into this room. Yeah, there you go, Rocket Bunny. I told you. There you go. So now you're all set up. Now you can definitely boot from a USB. You're good to go, man. And you can just get your Windows partition to fix the boot partition, and you'll be back to normal. And then what you can do is you can create a little USB key or USB thing that will boot you into Linux anytime you want. You don't even have to erase your Linux setup. You can keep it as it is, and then you can boot into Linux whenever you want. Doors, ship dungeon. I could do this in the world. I could retroactively apply the door locks to the dungeon's doors, or I could do this in dungeon where it's creating the doors. Yeah, I think it'd be better to do it in the dungeon. Yeah, is actually pretty easy. So if the dungeon type is K dungeon ship, we want to lock the key, the before boss room. So the key condition will become K num key types. Just num key types. Because we're using key 7, or was it key 8? Oh, this is, I think we're already using key 8. You're celebrating an error screen, right? Ah, the irony. Okay, yeah, that's key 8. So yeah, this needs to be key 7. Okay, this might work. I guess we could set a breakpoint and figure out what the doors are. Set a breakpoint for the ship dungeon. If it's the position that we're on, which is 6310. So I'm just going to set a breakpoint to verify if this worked. 6310. Oh, you said it type F12? Yeah. There you go. Oh, I can believe it, man. I can totally believe it. This happened to me too in college. And it was all because my friend wanted me to get Linux. He was like, I can do this. I can get you grub. I can get you all set up so you can dual boot. He was kind of an idealist. And he's a great guy. I'm just saying, like it was a funny moment because I was almost in tears because I couldn't get into my computer, my beloved computer. I couldn't play games. I couldn't do anything because we had tried to install Grub, and my friend was like, "I can get it back. I can get it working again. I'm just trust me." And I was like, "Oh no, my computer's broken forever. You ruined everything. I'm never gonna be able to code again." But he got it working, so. Lesson learned. Grub can be tricky, but like it's not too difficult to get things fixed if you want to go re-overwrite. Re-overwrite? Just overwrite. You just want to overwrite Grub. It's not too hard. This room, I just want to look at the doors. Where art thou doors? Here we go. Three doors. The door to the north. So this last one, 6-2, that's south. 6-4, here we go. Oh, it's a regular door. No key ignition. Damn it all. Huh. I wonder why that didn't work. Okay, I'm gonna set a breakpoint then back in dungeon. Oh, it might not have mirrored the door. Right? It might have locked the door inside the before boss room, but not the other door corresponding to it. That might have been what happened. Nice. Yeah, there you go. You could do it. You could probably do it today. Isn't there? Yeah, there's a big American holiday. This next week it's Thanksgiving. So actually tomorrow is the last day I'll be streaming this week because I'll be traveling. I'm going to see my family. Going to see my family pretty much the whole week. I got to get up there, spend time with them till the end of the weekend. So I'll be tomorrow will be my last stream until like the next Monday. So this room is three, four, zero. Oh, this is before it's normalized. Four, why? Yeah, this is definitely the room. Okay, so it looks like it's locking the door. Why doesn't it lock both doors? Oh, because it's the. What? Doesn't make sense. Oh, yeah. Okay. Because it's not necessarily tunneling into that door. All right, this is better to actually do it retroactively from the other way. Oh, yeah, you're preparing to only watch YouTube and Netflix? Yeah, I will. I'll definitely have fun. I'll go see my little nieces. My nieces are, I think they're 8 and 6 now. They're just cute as hell. So much fun to play with. They always say, "Let's play Bigfoot, Uncle Nat, Bigfoot." So they just want me to basically chase them around and growl like Bigfoot, and they're entertained for hours like that. Right? It's pretty nice, huh? Okay, so we're gonna lock the doors into the before boss room. Which means we need to know where the before boss room is. I I don't think dungeon has a function to find room, find things by a flag. Oh yeah, it does. Find room. Nice. Before boss pause equals dungeon dot find room, okay, flag before boss dot pause. Yo, Lime, what's up, Lime? Yeah, no long time no see, man. How you been, man? What's going on? How's the games? What are you working on now? All right, so if this, we just want to loop through all the doors. Yeah, I'm doing good, man. Really great. So many games, really? If the D dot dest. No, doesn't have dest. Yeah, D dot dest equals before boss pause. Then we want to change this door. D dot type equals K door locked. Yes, that's great though, man. Yeah, you've been streaming your own game dev, so how's it been going? Thank you, Lon. Appreciate it. Type locked and key condition. Is that an item type? No, that's an int. All right, so this is key condition K. Num key types minus one. So that's if the destination is the before boss, but what if the source is the before boss? Well, that's pretty easy. If Q equals before boss pause, so all the before boss doors will lock. Yes, hold off, man. Hold off. If you have any desire to hold off, I definitely recommend holding off because there's a lot of cool stuff coming out. Like what I'm working on right now. So good. We don't have the key yet to get into that. But if we did, right, same thing on this door here. But if we did, we got in here, these doors should be locked, all of these as well. Okay, good. We got locked doors for the four boss room. But now if we have the key, so now we need a story element to drop off the droid smith. Yeah, Summer Taco, it's a prefix. It means a constant. And it comes from Next Step, actually, and Objective C and all that. They started naming things constants with a K. Who knows why? And it stuck with me because I started my recent foray into coding games with Objective C games back in 2010. So I've just kind of adopted that K. I probably should switch back to C's. But what's up, Zeith? Yo. Okay, this is good though. We can check this in so far. Oh, wait. Let's just check. If I had the key, I can get into that door, right? Yeah, constant with the K, right? Why did they do that? Why did Next Step do that? It's their fault. Damn it. It's not my fault. Good. Okay, so if we have the key, we can definitely get in this door. Let's not have the key anymore. And the next thing to do is create a story element. Oh, yeah. You do the K thing too? Yeah. Okay, so we added some logic to make sure that it never creates an open wall going into the before boss room of the dungeon ship. And then this is it locks the doors going into the before boss room of the ship. That's okay, we're done. And that's done. So now we can drop the Smith off in the server room or the systems room or whatever. Thanks, Zeith. Oh, it's from math? Is that it? Here's the style. Is this the style? Yeah, it is. Right. Worst style ever. Oh, you like K better? K is pretty quickly read. C looks less obvious than K. We got some pros, man. We got some pros that use in K. I never knew there were any. All right, back to the start of this dungeon. And we need a story element for when we get the droid Smith to the room that he's trying to go to. So Smith door one, let's do Smith, we'll call this Smith drop when we drop him off the first time. So the Z is going to be 10. Pattern is ship systems. What is this abomination? Yeah. Constant with a K? That's what it means to me. Correct. So we're going to drop the Smith off if we're in this one room. We're not fluxing. We have idle dialogue, Smith drop. Item droid Smith. Three. Three for the droid Smith indicates that you've dropped him off. So zero indicates that you don't have the droid Smith quest. One indicates that you have the droid Smith quest to go pick him up. Two indicates you have the droid Smith with you. Three indicates that you've dropped the droid Smith off. Four will indicate that you've picked him back up after the ship starts to do its thing. So a lot of different variable, a lot of different variables there. Okay, now we just need a little bit of dialogue. Wait. Oh, we also need the item key A7. And that means that action item. There's two things we need to ignore. Oh yeah. Handmade hero. Sounds fun. So if the let's just do this manually. Like if item is K item key A7 or key A8, we're just gonna ignore them. Okay, now we see some dialogue. Smith drop one. Smith drop, Smith drop, Smith join. Where's the Smith join? We go. He is everything. Yeah, I like the low-level stuff too. I like the low-level stuff. And I think I might even do that someday. Like maybe Songbringer 2 or 3 or something like that, I could actually code an engine from the ground up. Because I don't know, Cocos 2DX is, it's okay. It's just bloated. It's really bloated. Smith drop one. All right, let's see if this works. Let's make sure this is like right. Like Z10 pattern ship Smith ship systems. You have Smith, you have the droid Smith item. You're not flexing, idle. Do some dialogue, change the item. It's lower level than an engine. How did you pick Cocos? I picked Cocos because it's C++ and it's familiar to an engine that I was already using called Cocos 2D. Cocos 2DX is just the cross-platform version. And not only is it C++, but it's cross-platform. That's very important things to me. I wanted to be able to write a game once and not have to port it to other platforms. I wanted it to just work on every platform. And I didn't want to have to spend a lot of time writing an engine at that point because I knew that it would take me like a year to write an engine. And this time could be better spent writing a game, at least in my opinion. But that's just a personal preference. Like, I would rather write a game than a game engine. So that's why I chose it. You want to be able to program Jib in game? Tits. That sounds like a cool idea. Here we go. Cool. Okay, so let's put him closer to the center of the screen. That will be. I'll need to create some, like, special, graphics for this screen. I'll do some pixel art for this to make it look like sort of like a. I'm thinking it'll kind of look like a server room because he's in here messing with the doors and getting them to be fixed. And so he'll be like, I think he'll go to like some kind of server wall type thing and start fixing it or whatever. And he talks all an alien. So great. What's up, like wise dog? Yeah, I work on this full time. The Jib API. Okay, so he just disappeared right there because. Oh shit! She shouldn't be here. Okay. Couple things. Let's add some uptime to this. And there should never be a foe in this room. Server hanging from the ceiling? That's cool. I like that idea. You wonder what he's saying? You're rich. I love that. Here we go. Faux pattern. Let's create a special faux pattern for ship systems. Pattern ship systems. Do nothing. No enemies. What's up, Hiths? Regretful Eskimos? Regretful Eskimos sounds like a really funny thing. I don't know what that is. Okay, I'm gonna save the game with this key. Make this a little easier. Okay, so the next thing we need to do is, when we're dropping off the smith in this room, he needs to not just disappear. Okay, so yeah, that's the next thing. Don't make the Jib, don't make him disappear. That's in create heroes. So the Smith needs to be the best gags? Regretful Eskimos? Is this a fan game? Nice. Nice. I like this Mega Man with the intense look. I should check this out. Add it to my list of games to play. I started playing Don't Starve, finally. Don't Starve's pretty fun. You've been at it since 9 a.m. Eastern time. Alright. Cool, Ishii. Thanks, you too, man. Yep, I'll be streaming tomorrow, and then the next time I'll be streaming will be the next Monday. Oh, I made a webcomic. Oh. Nice. Cool. Go check that out. So, if we're dropping off the droid smith, we need to, remove him from the heroes list. That's it, basically. Enter a flying pattern. Oh, yeah. That's cool. I like that. He moves around and does stuff. I was imagining he could use his like little his tools. So that would totally be the same kind of thing. So we need the quantity of Smith. All right, so we're dropping him off. I think that all that needs to happen here is just to. Oh, wait a minute. Yeah, okay, so there's going to be a couple special things that happen because later on you're going to be able to come back here and pick him back up. So he needs to, like, in this instance, when you walk onto the screen with him and then you, like, let him go from your party, he needs to just simply get off of the heroes list, I think. And then later on, if you go off the screen right away and you come back to that same screen after you've dropped him off, the screen will need to be smarter about how it creates another droid smith entity for him sitting there. Okay, so one thing at a time. If the id is greater than zero and we're not doing the smith, but if the quantity is three. This is where we just want to remove a hero. I don't know if Game Scene has a method already to be able to do that. I don't think it does. Game Scene just allows you to add heroes. Oh, wait, there is a remove hero. Oh, that's beautiful. Hey, nice. Remove hero. What does that do exactly? Does it delete the hero as well? I don't want it to delete the hero. I just want it to remove it from the heroes list. Hero id's a size. Erase elements from the hero ids if it's the exact id. Oh, yeah. It recreates the heroes list. Oh, sick. This function should already work. Game scene, remove hero. Okay, at first he's not gonna be smart. He'll just stop. But we'll make him smarter, so he'll go into this, like he'll have some kind of AI for, working in this room. This is kind of a long, involved quest to code, but I think it should be pretty interesting. And it really plays an important role in the whole plot of the game. Oh, he's still following. Oh, because he's in his follow mode still. But now that he's not part of the team, if I walk off the screen, he shouldn't follow. Yeah. Oh. He's still here. But I don't think he's part of the team, because if he was part of the team, he would walk with you. He's like staying in exactly the same position and just being moved. Which means his entity is still. What is these? I guess probably the thing to do here is to delete the droid smith and then recreate more of a static droid smith. Yeah. So we do want to destroy him, and then I guess the item, when you get the item, here, do that, and then action item is where it goes and recreates heroes if you get a hero item. Yeah, so we're converting hero smith to smith. Okay, so we need some special logic. If the quantity is 3, we want to create a droid smith entity. Which is, oh damn, it's a lot like this already. All right, so we get where the droid smith was. And then create an auto entity. And then, oh wait, just get its position component. Okay. And then, oh. And then just set him his position to the old position. Wherever you dropped him off. Yeah, Lime. We'll see you, man. Thanks for stopping by. Next time I want to hear more about your games you've been making. think that's how the create Smith tile works. Yeah, create being Smith. So it's a little bit different. Right, lades. Let's see if that worked. Yeah, good. We still have the droid smith just staying there, but at least he's not following us anymore. And if I go off the screen, he shouldn't follow anymore at all. Good, yay! Now, if I go back to the screen, he's not going to be there. So that'll be the next step, right? I need to recreate his entity inside this room. Yeah, there's a lot of stuff left to do, but I do got to take a break myself here and get some lunch, some dinner. Yeah, this is going to be it for today's stream. But what I'm going to do next is I'm going to turn this whole room into like a kind of like a server room or something like that, with lots of the different like controls and blinking lights and stuff like that. When you drop the Smith off, he'll go and he'll start working on the different like server things and using his tools and stuff like that, and moving around. And then if you go off the screen and you come back, it'll still recreate his entity here, and he'll be waiting here too for when you can pick him up later. So yep, that's it. We're about halfway done with this whole Smith quest. This is going to be a pretty important quest to the overall plot of the video game. So this is pretty good to have this all said and done, because it just means that Songbringer will have a story. So, see everybody. Thanks a lot for watching. And as always, I totally appreciate you all and all your support and ideas and encouragement and everything. So, we'll see you next time.